have breaking news.
That breaking news is out of Greenville County right now. Sky 4 is giving us a live look at the DMV at White Horse Road and Saluda Dam Road. We are told this is the end result of a chase out of Anderson County.
News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local at the scene right now. Myra, what can you tell us?
Well, Nigel and Gabby, from what we're hearing from the Anderson County Sheriff's Office, a woman called 911 after someone tried to break into her home, and that led to a pursuit. Now, that pursuit went all the way into Greenville County, and here's what is happening now near the intersection of White Horse Road and Saluda Dam Road here in Greenville County. No one is hurt at this point, but there is a standoff situation outside a DMV.
Joining us on the phone right now is Natasha Hall. Natasha, where are you located right now?
I am located inside the South Carolina Department of Transportation.
And what have you been told?
We've been told to lock the doors, no one in and no one out.
Obviously, this is a very tense situation. You're seeing it, people watching at home, you're seeing it unfold live. The man in question is the person in blue behind the back of that truck. Natasha, about when did this begin?
I guess it was around 3 o'clock. One of our coworkers, Tamika Riley, came in. And she said she saw the chase coming towards us, and she came in, and we locked the doors from there.
Can you actually see anything out of the windows, or are you guys basically on the ground? Tell me kind of your location right now.
He's right in our parking lot, and we can see everything that's taking place, basically.
We heard what sounded like a round of gunfire coming from the direction where all these deputies have surrounded the DMV office at Saluda Dam Road and White Horse Road. We do not know exactly what had happened there, or we're just still waiting for them to return here so they can give us an assessment. But we do know there were still people inside the DMV office. They were told to take shelter beforehand. Deputies said they didn't think it was safe for them to be outside.
A suspect is dead after 7 Greenville County deputies opened fire on him. They say he shot first. It all started today in Anderson County and ended at the DMV on Saluda Dam Road in Greenville County.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local from the scene tonight. Mandy, is the road still shut down tonight?
Well, yes, Michael, Saluda Dam is still shut down tonight. You can probably see the flashing lights behind me to my left. Since we're a little bit closer than we were earlier this evening, I also want to point out to my right that the wrecker is here, which I imagine is now towing away the suspect's vehicle. Now, investigators may be here for a while. This road may be shut down for a while because SLED is now on scene. They're investigating, which is normal procedure. I can also tell you that the 7 deputies involved in that shooting are now on administrative leave, which is also standard in a case like this.
This is how a standoff outside the DMV on Saluda Dam Road ended Tuesday. The suspect inside, Zachary Whitfield, pronounced dead at the hospital. Earlier, the SWAT team and investigators from at least 3 different agencies converged around a black Ford Explorer they'd been chasing since a burglary call in Anderson County. Deputies say non-lethal methods were first used to get the driver, Whitfield, to surrender, but say Whitfield shot back.
All I could do was pray. And I wish they would have let me go up there and just talk to him.
Friends and family were close to the scene while onlookers tried to figure out what was going on.
He's right here. No, he's gone again.
In this cell phone video taken by Adam Clardy, Whitfield's Explorer can be seen followed by several investigators through a busy neighborhood. Clardy says Whitfield drove through this area to see his father.
He actually stopped down at the corner another block down and stopped and talked to his mom and dad, and then he took off again.
That chase ended at the DMV, which is very close to where Whitfield lives. Sky 4 showed Whitfield getting out of his SUV and appearing to talk on a cell phone. About an hour later, the shooting happened.
We try to make an attempt to find peaceful resolutions to any situation. This is not what we want to see, obviously.
The 7 deputies involved in the shooting are now on administrative leave while the investigation continues.
Now, no deputies were hurt during all of this. I did try to talk to Whitfield's family. They had no comment tonight. I can also tell you that several people were stuck in and around the DMV inside buildings here. Deputies wanted them to stay inside for their safety. But I did talk to one woman by the phone today, and she told me, quote, "It was very shocking. It happened in the blink of an eye, and it was over." Of course, she was talking about the shooting.